Hello and welcome aboard. I'm Michael Barone, the Pipe Dreams guy, inviting you to join us for the first event in the 10th anniversary celebration of the East Texas Pipe Organ Festival. Now, the coronavirus pandemic has made it impossible for us to convene in person, but we're delighted to be able to bring you some brand new content and a remarkable roster of performers and repertoire in this virtual festival for 2020. As always, the festival celebrates the life and work of Roy Perry, whose legendary collaboration with the Aeolian-Skinner Organ Company, in partnership with the Williams family of savvy organ technicians, brought about some of the most distinguished representatives of the post-war American classic pipe organ style. In addition to our ongoing tribute to Roy Perry, we're also dedicating this 2020 festival to the memory of William Teague, who died this past June at age 97. Bill, for many years, was organist at St. Mark's Cathedral, Shreveport, and a loyal friend of the festival. Initiated by Lorenz, Maycher in 2011, the East Texas Pipe Organ Festival has been convening for a decade now. The primary purpose is to enjoy the variety of periolas, those instruments that benefited from Roy Perry's unique sense of color and balance. Chief amongst them is Opus 1173 from 1949 at First Presbyterian Church in Kilgore. This is the one that started it all, along with its younger, larger cousin at St. Mark's Cathedral in Shreveport, Opus 1308 from 1959. This year we'll also be enjoying the sounds of Aeolian-Skinner Opus 1110 at St. Stephen's Episcopal Church in Richmond, Virginia, and Opus 1275 at the Cathedral of All Saints in Albany, New York. These instruments making guest appearances possible only because of our extended online reach. And in addition to our opening recitalist, Jan Krabill, soloists that you'll hear during the next few days include Elizabeth and Raymond Chenault, David Baskyfield, Richard Elliott, Owen Reed, 16-year-old Wiz Simon Temple, and Faith Freeze, with a special online silent film accompaniment by the incomparable Clark Wilson, plus organ demonstrations in Kilgore and Shreveport by Casey Cantwell, and a special feature by Organ World luminary George Bozeman. We might even have some additional surprise guests, just to keep you on your toes. Artist biographies, programs, and program notes are all online. Just sniff around, either at easttexaspipeorganfestival.com or on this website. Do note that last year the Roy Perry American Classic Organ Foundation was founded as a nonprofit 501c3 organization to promote the legacy of Roy Perry, the organs he designed and finished, and the American Classic Organ ideal, through concerts, publications, recordings, educational events, and historic preservation. Since events at the East Texas Pipe Organ Festival, whether in person or online, don't happen by magic, your contributions are welcome at any time, either checks made to the Roy Perry American Classic Organ Foundation or donations made online. Remember, they are tax-deductible. You can find our mailing address on the ETPOF website. Playing upon the Aeolian-Skinner organ at St. Mark's Episcopal Cathedral in Shreveport, Louisiana, today's festival opening event performer is JAN KRAYBILL, internationally touring recitalist and Grammy-nominated recording artist. She's the organ conservator at the Kauffman Center for the Performing Arts in Kansas City, Missouri, and organist-in-residence for the Community of Christ's International Headquarters in Independence, Missouri. Also organist at Village on Antioch Presbyterian Church in Overland Park, Kansas. And when Jan is not tending to these various artistic responsibilities, and when the weather permits, you might find her out riding her Harley-Davidson motorcycle in the company of her husband. Jan's program covers a lot of territory, including three contemporary scores, the Opus 7 Preludes and Fugues by Dupre from 1914, the E minor sonata of James H. Rogers from 1910, and Siegfried Kargelert's Ein feste Burg fantasy, published in 1909. This concert is presented in memory of William Teague, who was organist and choir master at St. Mark's Cathedral from 1948 till 1984. The program underwritten by a generous gift from Chester H. Berry of Sandy, Utah. We're going to begin with something introspective in tribute to William Teague. It has importance at several levels. Setting a prayer of St. Ephrem of Syria, "Strengthen for service, Lord, the hands that holy things have taken." The tune Malabar was composed by the revered organist of St. Bartholomew's Church in New York City, David McKay Williams, a pupil of Vierne and Vidor. Leo Sowerby made an arrangement of the Malabar tune and dedicated it to Mr. Williams, who then included it in his publication, The Modern Anthology. Perhaps even more importantly, Sowerby, Roy Perry, and William Teague were great friends and often taught together at church music conferences. So there's a real family connection here. On with the show, though. Soon music by Dupre, James H. Rogers, and others. But first, the Leo Sowerby setting of Malabar, played by Jan Krabill at St. Mark's Cathedral in Shreveport. Thank you.
I'm so thrilled to be here at Opus 1308, the older sister of Opus 1309 of the Aeolian-Skinner Company, the Independence, Missouri instrument that I have the privilege of playing and overseeing. As siblings, they are very different, even though they're from the same family, and I am so thrilled to be back here at St. Mark's playing this glorious instrument. I'm grateful that we have this technology that allows us to share music making in this way, but at the same time, I can't wait till we're all together again, sharing music making together in a place. I'm grateful also to Lorenz Maycher for pivoting this festival and allowing it to still happen, and to his team that has been wonderful to work with making these recordings. And also to Bill Teague, in whose memory we play this year. And of course, this was his Aeolian-Skinner. It's such a privilege to be here. I'm also grateful to Chester Berry for underwriting this recital. Thank you, Chester. I've designed a recital, as I usually do, to address our times as well as containing great music. And this recital is no different. In fact, it's probably ever more so, trying to provide a bit of comfort and joy and inspiration from the notes that I play for those of us that are living in very challenging times. And I've been thinking about these preludes and fugues of Marcel Dupré. Dupré was in his 20s, undergoing a similar challenging time in the world with World War I and then the flu pandemic. And these three pieces are all dedicated to lost friends of his, friends who died during these challenging times. And I think that we can find some inspiration in the notes that he wrote. I hope you'll read the program notes that I've provided for this recital and learn about the three gentlemen to whom these preludes and fugues are dedicated. And I hope that you find some comfort in the beauty that Marcel Dupré created out of loss. May we all, in honoring Bill Teague, create beauty in his memory.
Thank you.
Paul Ayers and Jeff Wilkin are composer friends of mine. And in this COVID-defined time, in my attempts to provide my own videos online, I have been dealing with copyright issues, and Paul and Jeff both said that I could record their pieces, and I'm so grateful to them for writing the pieces and for allowing me to share them in my own video recordings. I want to play two of their pieces for you. The first, the aria by Paul Ayers, I think is a good illustration of our time when music making together is something that we've lost. So I'll be joined by a friend when you see this purple garbed arm come across that belongs to Lorenz Maycher, and I'm so grateful to him for joining me for a brief masked duet. And then the piece by Jeff Wilkin on the glorious hymn tune Thaxted was written for the dedication of a new organ, and so of course it uses all of this organ's resources to the utmost. Thanks, Paul and Jeff.
Thank you.
Artists and instruments featured on this East Texas Pipe Organ Festival program likely have appeared on a Pipe Dreams broadcast at one time or another. Indeed, I was the audio documentarian for a number of festival seasons in past years, summaries of which can be accessed in the archive at pipedreams.org. Just search for East Texas Pipe Organ Festival. And if you've enjoyed this special online presentation of the 2020 East Texas Pipe Organ Festival, virtually, remember that it is through the generosity of others and yourself, I hope, that programs such as this can be made available. Now, if you already have donated to access this program, we do appreciate that, certainly, but also encourage you to help us oil the gears for future activities of the East Texas Pipe Organ Festival machinery with maybe a little larger tax-deductible contribution. The website has all the information you need. Check it out. I'm Michael Barone, and I thank you for listening.